Using the Laplace transform to solve the initial value problem y double prime plus 4 y prime plus 3 y equals 1 minus u of t minus 2 minus u of t minus 4 plus u of t minus 6, and you are given y of 0 equals 0, y prime of 0 equals 0. So first we are going to use the derivative theorem to solve this problem. So I have s y capital Y of s minus s y of 0 minus y prime of 0. That's for the first term. The second one, I'm going to use a different color here to emphasize. And for s capital Y of s minus 4y of 0, okay? And the last one, just 3 times capital Y of s, alright? Now on the right side, take the Laplace transform of all of these. So I have L of 1 is 1 over s, L of this is e to the negative 2s minus e to the negative 4s plus e to the negative 6s. Is that done? No. Be careful. So this actually is 1 times u, okay? And when you take your Laplace transform, don't forget to include 1. So L of 1 is 1 over s, which is what I have here. So you need to include this, okay? Just a small number, just small number, but make a huge difference, okay? That's why this kind of tricked you, because they didn't write the number 1 down. And it's easy to see that because u times 1 is just itself, so why didn't they have to write 1, okay? But you have to know it, alright? Now let's take a look at the capital Y of s. And factor out capital Y of s. Then I have s squared plus 4s plus 3 in parentheses on this side. I have 1 over s minus 1 over s times e to the negative 2s minus 1 over s e to the negative 4s plus 1 over s e to the negative 6s. Y of 0 equals 0. This is gone. Y prime of 0 equals 0 is 0 as well. Alright. Now for this one, I'm going to divide both sides by this to get capital Y of s alone. Is this factorable? Yes, it is. And this factor is s plus 1 times s plus 3. Is it? Let's see. S where 3s plus 1 is 4. 3, yes. So I have s over s plus 1 times s plus 3 minus 1 over s times s plus 1 times s plus 3 times e to the negative 2s minus 1 over s times s plus 1 times s plus 3 times e to the negative 4s plus 1 over s times s plus 1 times s plus 3 times e to the negative 6s. Oh, this problem is not hard, but it's just lengthy, as I can tell, okay? Because these are similar, these are the same, so it's just lengthy. Alright, I cannot use the shortcut here, so we have to fall back using traditional way. So what I have is 1 over s times s plus 1 times s plus 3 equals a over s plus b over s plus 1 plus c over s plus 3. Okay, and the LCD is everything on the numerator on the left side. Multiply by that LCD, I have a times s plus 1 times s plus 3 plus bs s plus 3 plus cs s plus 1, right? So some of you might multiply this out, but for me, I wouldn't do that. What I'm gonna do is to use a leave it like this and use the limit. So let s approach 0. On the left side, I have 1. On the right side, is eliminate distances. So I have 0, 1, plus 1 times 3, which is 3, equals 3a. So within a second, I got a equals 1 third, right? Now do the same thing for the rest. Let s approach 1. Now let's approach negative 1. So negative 1, I have 0, negative 1, 0. It eliminates this and this, so I have 2. 2 times negative 2b. So b equals negative 1 half. Let s approach negative 3. On the left side, still 1. On the right side, it eliminates this and this. So negative 3 plus 1, negative 2, negative 2 times negative 3, positive 6. C. Then c equals 1 6. Okay? Now we are going to plug this back in here. Okay, let me move this up a little bit. Let me ring it down here. So y of s equal to yes, yes. So this, same with this, so I have 1 over, oops, a over s, and a is 1 third. 1 third over s. Plus b over s plus 1, b is negative 1 half. Over s plus 1, c over s plus 3 and c is 1/6, okay? Now for this one, basically, it's the same, it's similar to this, but it's multiplied by e to the negative 2s. So let's see, is there any other solid way? So let me combine these together. Let me try to line these up with the steps. So I'm going to factor out 1 over s times s plus 1 times s plus 3 for all these. So I'll do this first. And in parentheses, I have so 1 minus e to the negative 2s minus e to the negative 4s plus e to the negative 6s. Okay, a similar way. Okay, put parentheses around it. And for this one, just rewrite it. Alright, now it's time to take the inverse on the left side and y of t on the right side. Hold on. Okay, so, like I said, I factor this out and make it similar, but when I take the inverse, I have to multiply this out again. It's tedious. Anyway, let's multiply it now. So we have 1/3 of s, but I'm going to multiply it out in some way to save time. So I have 1/3 s plus negative 1/2 s plus 1 plus 1/6 over s plus 3. Okay, distribute this over here. Distribute this over every single term here, okay? But I just distribute it over this one and keep all these the same. And you will know why later. Okay, now take the inverse of these. On the left side, I have yt, of course. For this one, I have 1/3 minus 1/2 e to the negative t plus 1/6 e to the negative 3t. Okay, now for this one. Oh man, I thought I could do it that way, but it's not. Shoot. Sorry, guys. I have to distribute every single term here. Okay. Plus 1/3 over s plus negative 1/2 over s plus 1 plus 1/6 over s plus 3 times negative e to the negative 4s plus 1/3 over s plus 1 negative 1/2 over s plus 1. Just rewrite all these. Okay. Now take the inverse. For this one, it's 1/3 minus 1/2 e to the negative t plus 1/6 e to the negative 3t. Plus this one is 1/3 minus 1/2 e to the negative t minus 2y. Because you have this. Actually, negative sign in front. That is u of t minus 2. Okay? So you need to have the t match up. Plus 1/6 e to the negative 3t. And again, t has to match up, so which is t minus t minus 2. Then follow the same, following the line down here. Minus u of t minus 4. You know what's going to be, okay? Copy all these except the t. E to the negative t minus, so minus 4. This one. U of t minus 6. 1/3 minus 1/2 e to the negative t. Minus 6 plus 1/6 e to the negative 3 t minus 6. Okay, oh my goodness. So, okay, let me explain why I intended to put all these together, but why I couldn't do that because of this. You see, the u values are different, and the t's are different as well. Okay, so if you put them all together, it's gonna be just 1t and multiply all the factor in parentheses, but it doesn't work that way, right? Because you have different t. Right, t minus 2, t minus 4, t minus 6, for every single u. Okay, so that's why I thought I could do this, but it didn't work out that way. Alright, that's it. If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.